Good morning, everybody. Today is December 3rd, 2022. Welcome to the Box Office Artist Show. I don't know the name of the show. Maybe I should name the show. Should I name the show the James Ray Show? You know, because Marvel style, that's what we're doing. But, you know, it's our chance to talk, to hang out, to talk about today's topics and all of that. I'm going to try to make this as entertaining as possible for you. My name is James Race. I am the Box Office Artist. Hello to everybody coming into the live chat right now. I see you. And if you want to be part of the show today, first of all, thank you to everyone who suggested what we are going to draw while I talk today. And we're going to do some fun stuff. As you see from someone gave a comment yesterday about doing the Kool-Aid Man. And I thought that was great. Now, you guys know I've done brands before. I have done food mascots before, or like fast food mascots before. I've done cereal mascots before. So I thought it would be fun to do some brand mascots this morning. Just a little bit out of the norm, something a little bit different. And hopefully you enjoy that. So first of all, hello to my good buddy Mario in the chat here, holding the fort down. Everyone go subscribe to Mario. Mario's the best. And if you guys want to be a part of the show today, if I could get my mouse up here, you guys want to be a part of the show today, whatever we talk about, because we got some interesting topics to talk about today, go to the community chat. All right. So everybody watching live on YouTube, go to the community chat right here. Okay. Where you see up here, the tab says community. Okay. If you have the YouTube app, go to my page again. So we'll go to my channel, go to my channel here. Okay. Go to community. Okay, and be here, right here. Be a part of the show. I want you to be a part of the show. Hit comments, okay? And then add your comments right there, okay? So add your comments right there. Any questions, you can ask me anything you want. But especially if you want to talk about some of the topics that I'm going to talk about today. Just a couple topics. There's not much news today, but there is a couple things that I want to touch on before going to your comments today. So, well, I go ahead and we're going to start by drawing the Pillsbury Doughboy today. With bad day for Mario. Mario Ultimate Art is fasting today. So no food today. How long is your fast, Mario? Is it like one of those 24-hour fasts? Or are you going crazy like one of those 7-day fasts that I see people do? So I did not fast yesterday. I ate a lot yesterday. Definitely ate a lot yesterday. But we're going to go ahead and I'm going to go ahead and start drawing this Pillsbury Doughboy in a Marvel style. This is going to be a lot of fun. Now, one thing I did want to talk about today. 24-hour fast for Mario. One thing I did want to talk about today, guys. The machines are taking over. The machines are taking over, my friends. And I'm not talking about Transformers Rise of the Beast trailer. I'm not Webmaster. I'm talking about the machines. I'm talking about AI. As I go ahead and take a sip of my club soda here. That's one of the few things I could drink. Take a little cup of soda. My friends, last night I was on Twitter and everybody I was following, they were all generating AI art. All of them. Everybody was getting their fate. You know, a lot of people I follow, I forgot which AI generator it was, but it was like facial recognition. And they were all making crazy artworks of themselves through AI art. And they were in all different styles. All different styles. My friend Guava Juice was doing it. And they looked incredible, man. I'm telling you. I'm telling you. Call it, you know, some of you might not call that art, to each his own, for sure. But I'm looking at this stuff and I'm like, man, our job's done, guys. It's done. I am setting the alarm right now. Ding, 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 ding. The artist alarm right now. That's what this podcast is. It's a warning, my friends. It's a warning. I'm looking at this. I'm looking at the art that's generated. I'm taking a look at the art that's generated. And I'm like, guys, we are turning into cab drivers. We are turning into, what's it called? We are turning into the horse and buggy drivers before the cars came along. Before the cars came along. That's, guys, a lot of you guys want to be artists. And I am telling you right now, guys, you're going to need to figure out, like, I'm an old guy. I might be able to get away with not doing this stuff. But for you young guys here, like, this is the future. It really is. The AI art is here to stay. It's not going anywhere. And you're foolish to put your head in the sand and think that it's just a fad is going somewhere. It's not. Because people are generating, whether you think it's art or not, some people are saying it's not art because it's not generated by human. Okay, that's fine. But I'm looking at these images and it's like, they're so good. It looks like an artist did them, right? At a time when people would have paid a lot of good money for people to do this for them. I am looking at this stuff last night and I was like, oh man. Like I talked about before, we talked about AI art before on my streams. And my main thing is with AI art is that it's not necessarily people who like artists that are going to stop watching artists or going to artists. No, it's the brands. It's the people who want commercialized art that are going to stop going to artists because AI art, it's cheaper and it's faster. It's way cheaper and it's way faster. And I'm looking at this stuff and I'm like, these things are done literally in minutes. Minutes. It's done. When it would take an artist like days, weeks, literally minutes for them to do. And then I'm watching one of my favorite artists of all time. Have any of you guys heard of Dynatomic? Have you guys ever heard of Dynatomic? He's one of my favorite artists. One of the most innovative artists I've ever seen. And he created pages upon pages of AI art. And they all looked amazing. He drew like these babies as superheroes. These babies as superheroes. So go look up. Guys, go look up Dynatomic, D-I-N-O-T, Tomic, right? One of the most amazing artists I've ever seen in my life. And he was jumping on the AI art bandwagon. And he was like, guys, this is the future. This is tools. These are tools. And it is, guys. And I'm telling you right now, a lot of you guys are very, very young. Jump on this now. Jump on it now. Don't wait. Like, because I only see it getting better. It's not going to stop. The only one who wants to stop it is artists. And guys like me, the only ones who want to stop it are guys like me coming around. They think that's not real art. But it's cheaper. It's faster. And the people who are able to incorporate it, the people who are going to be able to incorporate AI art into their own artwork, they're going to be the ones who are the future. They're going to win. Because why would people waste their time? Time, you know, the biggest commodity people have these days is time, right? And if it takes a few clicks of a button for someone to, if it only takes a few clicks of a button for someone to generate a piece of art that would have took artists weeks to do, right? Why on earth would they go to an artist? Why? Unless they were an actual fan of artists. Right. So I don't mean to be all doom and gloom to start this show off here today, but I'm watching this stuff yesterday. I'm like, man, this is the future. This is it. And which makes me concerned for you guys. I'm not too concerned about myself, mainly because, Well, I should be concerned about myself. I just say that. I should be concerned about myself. But especially for you guys. A lot of you guys want to draw comic books. A lot of you guys want to do concept art. Like, why even have a concept art team when you could just say, okay, make a Captain America, make his outfit blue, and give me like 20 versions of it. And you click a button, and then that's going to happen. Right? It's like, no, that's the future, guys. It's here. And I'm telling you right now, don't stick your head in the sand about this. This is the biggest thing to ever come along in art ever. It's the biggest thing. More than digital art. Now, again, people were saying this about digital art. People were saying this about people who use photos, like guys like Boss Logic. People are saying this about him using photos to make the images that he makes, you know? And then that started to become accepted. And now this AI guys, don't sleep on it. Please, please, all of you who are artists, I'm telling you right now, what you're seeing me doing here right now, this might be going the way of again, this is the cab. This is the horse and buggy before cars came along. This is the cab before Uber came along, right? So I came today with a warning, my friends. I came today with a warning. So before, like, it didn't bother me in a sense before, but now it's like I am concerned. I am concerned because it's not going away. It's not going away. So please, everybody, like even Lulian is thinking about making a comic book. You know what, Lulian, with this new technology, you could even just think the comic book now. You could even just think of the comic. You could even just put in the script. Why would these writers need artists now? They can literally put in their script, right? Now, the technology is not 100% there, but it will come. They're just going to be able to write in the script in this program. Put the script in and, you know, just say, okay, I want it in a Jim Lee-like style. And then press a button and boom, there it is. It's not true, Kingfire. That's not true. He says, do not do AI art every piece I do now. Everybody will think it's fake. You know what? Nobody cares. We care because we're artists. But the regular folk, they don't care. They just think it's a cool picture. And for the first, they love it. The regular people, the non-artists, they love it. Because the first time they could create art without us. Without someone who studied art, right? Without someone who studied art. They love it. And they're the ones with the money. They're the ones who pay us. You know? So, guys, the ones who are going to win. Okay? You want to do art for a living. You want to do art for a living. The ones who are going to win are the people who take advantage of this technology. If you want to win, if you want to have a good future in art, you got to figure out how to use this stuff. Okay? And it's not hard. Because I see everyday people using it last night. Everyday people. And I need Pillsbury Doughboy reference here, guys. Just give me a second. That's why I stopped drawing for a second. Because I got all excited about this AI art. I didn't mean to start today all gloom and doom, my friends. All gloom and doom. Now, you know, if you want to ignore it, go for it. Go for it. If you want to ignore it, go for it. It's your life. It's my life. It's my dream. That's Perfect Strangers, by the way. For those of you who are old. But it's here to stay. I really do believe that. So, will I play around with it? Maybe. I might play around with it because actually, even for me, as an artist, like, I actually do work on these, I work on these animated shorts, guys. I'm working on this project with animated shorts and I'm doing these backgrounds. And even me, I'm like, it'd be easier if I just use AI to do it. Because I have no interest in doing those backgrounds. well, it's not that I don't have any interest, but I'm looking like I could probably get backgrounds that are, you know, faster. AI for it. So I'm actually seriously considering me, an artist, who's made my entire career is drawing art. I'm looking at this AI, I'm like, man, this is going to make my job faster. So I could work on other things. You know, guys, if you ever just start business, art or no, the best businesses are the ones that save time. It's always the best business. Anything that could save humans time, they're the ones who are going to win. That's why Uber came around, right? That's why Uber works so well. Like, yes, it's banned in certain places. Cabs hate it. Okay? Of course, cabbies hated it, but it saved time. That's why I use Uber. Or Lyft or any of those ride shares. Because it saves time. I could track it. You know, time and ease. That's the name of the game. Time. So even me, I'm looking like I could do these backgrounds way faster if I use AI. So there you go. You know? So. Well, here's the deal, Kingfire. So Kingfire looks like I spent 3 hours on our piece and now AR is going to kill me. It kills everybody. Like, literally, guys, go to Dinotomic. Go to Dinotomic's Instagram page. I can spell it right now. Dinotomic. He put up pages upon pages of AI art that would have taken him weeks to do. And he's an artist. He knows that. But all of this art is just as good, if not better, than anything he's put out. Anything he's put out. So I'm going to tell you guys, young, old, whoever's watching here, if you want to be an artist, start to learn these programs. Start to learn it. Which programs? Google it. Google it. I'm not going to waste time here, doing the Google joke, because that's how serious this is. Google it and figure it out. Okay? I care about you guys. I want you to succeed. I want you to have a bright future. You guys, don't bury your head in the sand. Please study it and see if you could incorporate it in your work. See if there's a way you could incorporate it in your work. Even those of you who are want to be YouTubers, is there a way you could incorporate AI into your work? I know Jazz has played around with it a lot. Is there something you could do with this technology? Because everybody's using it. People that used to come to me for art, they don't need to anymore. My friends, they just went into the program, and I'm looking at the images that are coming out, and I'm like, that's better than I could do. A lot of these images, that's way better than I could do. So, again, guys, yeah, go for it. Yeah, Kingfire is only very young. Kingfire is very young. Kingfire, you more than anyone needs to start learning this stuff. You more than anyone needs to start learning this stuff. Because, you know what, by the time you get to my age, there probably will be no more artists by the time you get to my age. Learn coding, man. Learn coding. Learn these computers. So, anyway, that's enough doom and gloom. Okay, guys, I'm the only reason I'm saying this because I was watching this last night. When I saw Dinotomic post all that stuff yesterday, I was like, man, it's done. It's done. So, will there always be a market for someone who could draw traditionally? Sure. But that market is closing. Or there's not as many people interested in seeing this. Now, you know, there is value. Like, people like watching people create art online because it's soothing. So that you don't get, but you never know with AI art. That day might come where you could produce videos like that. And it's not just us, guys. It's actors. It's anyone in creative fields, like computers. Taking over, guys. Computers taking over. So, anyway, guys, that's enough gloom and doom. For now, I'll just, again, don't sleep on AI art. Do your due diligence, okay? Don't run away from technology. Learn from it and see how it can apply to you. Because that was my career too. Growing up, like, I still draw traditionally, but you know, the advent of computers, learning 3D, all of that stuff, definitely helped me in the future. Okay, so. Again, don't sleep on it, guys. Keep going. Okay, so that's enough doom and gloom about that. Let's get to some topics today. Okay, so first of all, one thing I did want to talk today about was the Streamy Awards. Okay, so you guys know what the Streamy Awards are? You ever heard of the Streamy Awards? The Streamy Awards is the internet version of the Oscars, as we like to say. It's where YouTuber and creators, I won't say just YouTubers. Before, we used to be just YouTubers. Now, but creators as a whole, they get recognized at this thing called the Streamy Awards. Now, a couple things I wanted to do. I wanted to talk about my experience at the Streamy Awards. For those of you who didn't know, in 2018 and 2019, the Streamy Awards hired me to draw all the winners of the show. They thought it would be fun. That when the winners were presented, that they show a drawing video of, you know, of my hand drawing the winners. Okay, so if you actually look that up, if you looked up James Ray's or Box Office or Streamy Awards, you'll actually see a lot of the videos on Twitter. You'll see a lot of those winning videos on Twitter. So let me tell you how I got that particular job here. As I give the doughboy, he's not very doughy, is he? This doughboy, he's not very doughy. Not very doughy, is he? So I was contacted as in 2018. So I didn't have a million subscribers yet. At that time, I had about 400,000 subscribers around that time. Still quite substantial. And then they contacted me and they said, hey, look, James, we have the Stream Awards coming up. We think it'd be a great idea if you could go and draw all the winners to the Stream Awards. And then we will actually fly you out to Los Angeles. And, At first, they didn't offer to fly me out to Los Angeles. At first, they didn't. I asked, okay, I'll do it, but it was part of the payment. Because I was actually giving them a little bit of a discount. I won't say a lot of big discount, but, I was giving them a little bit of discount. I said, look, why don't you, if you could bring me there to LA, be a part of the Streamies, then I'll do it. So that's what they did. They actually flew myself and my oldest daughter down to the Streamy Awards. So I had, I think, a week to draw all of the winners at the Streamy Awards. This is 2018. So I drew them. Each one I drew, like, just one of these boards, that size. And I had to go ahead and, try to get those likenesses right. And that's always the hardest thing, getting the likenesses right. But I didn't have much time to do it at all. I had a week to draw all the winners of all the awards. So it's a little nerve-wracking, too, at the same time, because they, first of all, they had to tell me the winners. So I was the only one who knew who the winners were on that day already. Because they gave it to me a few days earlier. So I did all those drawing videos. I think the first year, who did I draw? A lot of and that's the interesting thing. This experience, guys. After this experience, it actually is the reason why I don't really draw YouTubers anymore. I don't really draw YouTubers anymore because the reason I don't draw YouTubers anymore is because you don't know what's going to happen in the future with these YouTubers. Because you don't mind being associated with them one day, but then the next day, you kind of don't want to be associated with them anymore, if you get my drift. If you get my drift, huh? For example, I drew David Dobrik a lot because he won a lot of awards. I think he won the first year, he won an award. And then the second year, he won like 3 awards, if I'm not mistaken. So I drew him a lot. And I took a lot of pictures with David Dobrik. But then he got canceled. Right? But then he got canceled. So what do I do? Do I hide? Do I hide those drawings I did of him? And they're like, nah, just leave it up. Like, if anyone says anything, I'll just tell them I drew that before he got canceled. But it's not just him. There are a lot of people I drew. They got canceled right afterwards. A lot of people I drew, they got canceled afterwards. But I remember the first year, I got to draw some cool people like Markeith Brownlee. And so the first year, who was the creator of the year that year? See, another one, like Shane Dawson. I drew Shane Dawson. Talk about canceled. Right? I drew him. He was the creator of the year that year. I think it was 2018. He was the creator of the year then. So the first year, they flew myself and my daughter over there. And it was great. I forgot the name of the guy I was working with. But Michael. His name is Michael. Wonderful guy. His name is Michael. Michael Alvarado. Wonderful guy. Would work with him again in a heartbeat. Great guy. So they brought me over there to the Streaming Awards, and it was fun seeing all these actors. Now, I will say this, guys. You could tell the difference between a trained performer and a YouTuber. It's two different things. Because I'm sitting down here and I'm watching this show. Okay? And, you know, when you're used to watching things like the Oscars, or you're used to watching things like the Emmy Awards and all that, and I'm sitting here. And I swear, like, the Streamy Awards, you know, as much as I appreciate them bringing me over there and watching the Streamy Awards, it's one of the most cringiest shows to watch. It really is. And it's not because, not without trying. You know, of course, they were trying to put the best show on as possible. But these guys, these creators, they're not, for the most part, a lot of them are not trained performers. They're not. They're like you and me. They're just regular people that were able to build a following. They're not, you know, they're not trained actors. A lot of them are not. A lot of them are. But a lot of them are not. You know? Like, would I be able to do any better? No, absolutely not. I wouldn't have been able to do. But a lot of things they did on that show, I was like, ooh. I'm watching that show. And I'm like, oh, my, wow. Was not good. Was like from the speeches to the way they presented to the, you know, they start doing like all these inside jokes sometimes for their friends. So you hear the odd. So they would try to do these jokes and then they would laugh at their own jokes. And then you'd have like the odd one or two people in the crowd laughing that are their friends. So they're just playing to their friends. Like it's one of the cringiest things, man. And this was 2018. This was pre TikTok explosion. So I could only imagine today, that room being filled with TikTokers, how much even more cringier it would be. You know, with all these TikTokers there. And again, they're not trained professionals, right? So I'm not expecting the quality of like of an Oscars or a big show like that, where you actually have trained professionals hosting a show. So I think it was a little more like with the press. It's like people who got tickets but weren't really fans of YouTube. It was like that. But, you know, we went. It was fun. And then it was fun just trying to find, you know, trying to meet all of these creators over there. Okay, because the first year when I went with my daughter, we got to meet people like the offline TV guys. Like I got to meet Pokimane. I didn't know who she was at that time. I didn't know who Pokimane was at that time. My daughter did, though. She really wanted a picture with Pokimane. Like, people like Alex Wasabi met him. He was a really nice guy. He was a really nice guy. Of course, David Dobrik and his crew, they were actually really nice. They were really nice. Because I remember them looking at my art afterwards because they won like best crew or something like that. And I met a few of those guys there, David Dobrik's crew. And they were trying to figure out who was who in the picture. They were trying to figure out who was who. Now, for the most part, you could tell who was who. For the most part, you could tell who was who in the picture. But there was a couple that they didn't know who it was. Who else did I meet that first year? Oh! I met Logan Paul that year. I met Logan Paul. And I got a picture with Logan Paul. There. This was after the... Which fight was this? 2018. Was that the KSI fight? I think that was the KSI fight. After the KSI fight. Because I met him. He was walking by and I took a picture with him. And then you realize how short I am. Next to a guy like Logan Paul. Logan Paul's like what? 6'2"? So, you know, for a while, I you know, I had to hide that picture of Logan Paul. Now I can share that picture, no problem. It just shows you, you know, if your people are able to get uncanceled, right? Logan Paul is a prime example of somebody who gets uncanceled. Because before, I couldn't show that picture to anybody. But now I can. I can show you guys that picture of me and Logan Paul together, right? But you know, you would see there's pictures of me walking around that particularly Streamy Awards, and I had this giant envelope in my arm. And that was all the winners' drawings. Was that the first year or the second year? Actually, now I'm thinking about it. It might be the second year, 2019. I'm trying to think about that. But The first year I was on an extreme diet. The first year, because, you know, we just found out my wife had cancer. So I was trying to, we went to this doctor that, you know, this is one of those naturopathic doctors. You know, we were doing everything we can to try to prolong her life, right? So, and the naturopath doctor put her on this really crazy diet. And I wanted to be supportive. So I was doing the same diet. So I couldn't enjoy the food when I was at the Streamy Awards. I couldn't enjoy that much because I was on this crazy, crazy diet here. All I was eating was like fruit and vegetables. That was it. I was just eating fruit and vegetables. So I couldn't enjoy the sliders or they had a lot of good food there. They had it catered. A lot of good food at the Streamy Awards. So, you know, and then afterwards I ran around because they took the drawings and they framed them. So actually now thinking about it, that Logan Paul picture was 2019. Now that I'm thinking about this, but 2018, they framed all the pictures and then they gave it to the winners. They gave it to the winners afterwards. So after the show, I ran around trying to get photos with as many of the winners as I could. So, you know, I went and I got pictures with Jay Shetty. I got pictures with Markeith Brownlee. Who else did I get pictures with? Matt Stefanina. He's a dancer. And anyone I could really. So I went there, you know, so I got to meet a few guys like the Good Mythical Morning guys, Rhett and Link. I met them. I had a picture with them. The Fine Brothers. The Fine Brothers still relevant, guys. The Fine Brothers still around. I think the React channel is still around, but you know, you hardly hear about the Fine Brothers these days. But the Fine Brothers, took a picture with them. So that was fun. It was a lot of fun meeting all of these celebrities. Well, they're not celebrities, let's be honest. These creators. That's a better word for it, creators. So, you know, that was one and done, and you know, I enjoyed that. And I didn't think they would contact me again. But then the next year in 2019, they contacted me again. A different management. That was another reason why I didn't think they were going to contact me again, because my friend Michael, he didn't stop working for them before. So the people who ran the show, it's Dick Clark Productions. Okay, so they do a lot of the award shows. They do it, so they produced the show, and my friend Michael he stopped working for them because he wanted to work on his own independent films. But then they contacted me again, and they said, "Hey, we liked what you did last year. We like what you did last year. Why don't you, if you could come and do it again, if you could come for the same price, that'd be even better." And I'm like, "No, I need a raise. I'm like, no. Send me over there, bring me again. I want a little bit of a raise." And then this time around, I didn't want to watch the show, okay? I didn't want to watch. But I remember, though, too, the first time around, the first show around, one of the people I drew was Emma Chamberlain. Have you guys heard of Emma Chamberlain? A gigantic YouTuber, but now she's like a big podcaster now. And she's doing a lot of things. Like, talk about someone who was able to grow their YouTube presence into a full, like, Hollywood career. Emma Chamberlain's one of those. Liza Koshy also won the first year. I got to draw Liza Koshy, but I didn't get to meet her. But Emma Chamberlain, she won an award, and she had the most cringiest speech you'd ever hear. It was one of the worst acceptance speeches. People are talking about that speech to this day. It was so bad because it sounded like she didn't want to win. She's like, "Oh, like, thanks for this award. Like, thanks, I got the word, but thanks." It was like that. It was one of the worst speeches I've ever heard. And I, you know, talk about cringe. That was the cringiest thing on that show. And she still tries to live that down today, that speech, because everybody still talks about it. But anyway, so the next year I got smarter, you see. So I said, okay, I don't want to watch the show. I want to be backstage. And I want to take pictures with everybody who wins an award, right? Oh, talk about fake people, comic book Bob. Wait till it lets you hear this part. So that was our agreement, okay? So not only would I do the draw all the winners. I wanted to be backstage. I wanted to be the one to give them their artwork. That's what I told them. That's what I wanted, right? So, and they agreed to that. They agreed to that. So I was backstage. And I got my daughter to film backstage. And there were some close calls. Because I would see people walk down. I didn't know they were hosts. I thought they got their award already. So I almost gave them their drawing. I almost gave them their drawing and they didn't win yet. So I almost spoiled the fact that they won one of the awards. But there was a guy back there that helped me a lot. I forgot his name, but he helped me a lot. But then I got to meet a lot of the winners there. I got to meet MatPat. You guys know MatPat? MatPat, one of my favorite channels, Film Theory. I got to meet him. He was shaved bald because he lost a bet. But he was shaved bald at that time. I got to meet him. I got to meet a guy named Jax Films. But one person I saw backstage, guys, was Paris Hilton. You guys know Paris Hilton, right? She's probably not as famous as she used to be. And she was famous for a variety of reasons. Let's just leave it there. Family show. But I got to meet Paris Hilton. Well, I didn't get to meet her. She was walking by backstage. And talk about fake. Talk about fake. Like, cause she walked backstage, and then there was this other girl there. I think she's a singer. I have no idea who she was. The singer, and she walks up to Paris Hilton. I'm watching this backstage. She's walking to Paris Hilton, and they had one of the most fakest conversations you ever seen in your life. Because you know there were a lot of these entertainment media back there, like Entertainment Tonight and all that stuff, and they were filming them. And they were filming this conversation. They were like, "Oh wow, wow, good to see you. Oh man, oh wow, yeah. Oh, how are you? Oh yeah, I'm good. Oh yeah." It's like, I'm watching, like, what is this? Now, again, how would I react? I'm trying to have a conversation with somebody with all this media around me, filming every second. Okay, I wouldn't have done any better. I definitely wouldn't have done any better. But it just, you know, when you're watching this and you're like, oh, like, yeah, like you see how people act in front of cameras, right? But, you know, I was so excited because one of the winners that year was Mr. Beast. Mr. Beast did win that year. So I was so excited to give him his award. So I drew Mr. Beast. I was so excited to give him his award, and he didn't show up. Mr. Beast hardly shows up to stuff like this, to awards and stuff. He'd rather work than go to these rinky-dink award shows to collect an award. Maybe, like, I'm not sure if that's changed or not, but he'll only do it if he feels he could, you know, if it's part of a video or something. So unfortunately, I didn't get to meet Mr. Beast. I was two guys I was looking forward to meeting on that day. Mr. Beast and Binging with Babish. Speaking of a chef here, I'm drawing the Pillsbury Doughboy here. He's not so doughy anymore. But Binging with Babish, I wanted to meet too because I was a big fan of his content as well, of Babish. But I did get, again, I did get to meet MatPat. And again, speaking of people who got canceled, there's a bunch there that got canceled recently. Like, oh yeah, okay, I won't say who got canceled, but yeah. And I got to meet Casey Neistat. I got to meet Casey Neistat there. And that was good. Like, after the show, I saw him twice. He was backstage. It was funny. It was just him. It was like me and my daughter backstage, and him and Tana Morneau, they were just yapping it up backstage. It was very interesting. Tana Morneau won Creator of the Year that year. Don't ask. Tana Morneau won Creator of the Year. This was in 2019, I believe. 2019, pre-pandemic. And her and Casey, they were just yapping it up. Her and Casey Neistat, like, blah, 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 blah. So, yeah. Well, I will say this though, Bob. I don't do cancel culture. Me too. But this particular person got canceled for good reason. They got arrested. This particular person got arrested recently because this person's kind of interesting. Let's just say that. So, but I got to meet Casey afterwards. Like, afterwards, everyone was taking a picture with Casey, and I took a picture with Casey. I told him that he was a big reason I was doing YouTube. I quit my job because of him. Like, he was one of the main reasons. He goes, that's what I like to hear. And then I'll take it back. That's where I did meet Logan Paul, was the 2019 one. I met him there. I got to meet Jay Shetty there in person. Wonderful guy. Jay Shetty. And I got to meet Markeith Brownlee. If any of you guys are into tech YouTube. So I got to meet all of these creators there. That was also the one I got to go see Guava Juice afterwards. Guava Juice invited me to his studio, which is really, it's always really nice to see somebody's creative space. So Guava Juice invited me. He put me in one of his videos that time. So that was a lot. It was a lot of fun. It was a good experience. Very, very good experience. And now, I don't think the Streamy Awards were too happy with my work the second time around. They didn't like my work the second time around. I will say, that's really not cancel culture. That's breaking the law. You're absolutely right there, Bob. You're absolutely right there. But the Stream Awards weren't really happy. Like, they didn't like the way I drew David Dobrik. Like, he won again. I told you guys that. He won again. And they didn't like the way I drew him. I had to redraw David Dobrik. I think around six times. But that's part of the job. If it doesn't look like him, it doesn't look like him. So I drew him. I had to draw him like 5-6 times, David Dobrik. And so I got a picture. I got a picture again with him afterwards. David Dobrik. He has his own pizza company now. I think it's called Dobrik's. That's the name of his pizza company. But there you go. But anyway. Anywho. That was my experience. Oh, and I got to meet my friend Mikey Bustos over there. And RJ. We have a lot in common because we're both Filipinos from Canada. From Toronto. And we both tried out for Canadian Idol, though he actually got far in Canadian Idol. I didn't. So it was nice to meet them. And then afterwards, there was this after party, right? So we all got invited to this after party. And we all got invited to this after party. And then I went with my daughter. But then I couldn't get in. I couldn't get into the after party because my daughter was underage at the time. She was 15 at the time, so didn't realize you had to be 18 to get into the party. So we had to miss the party. So yeah, it was a fun experience. It's always nice to have that freelance experience in that sense. Because you hope it would lead to other things. Like I you would hope that maybe this would lead to me doing this for because Dick Clark Productions. They do a lot of the award shows. And I was like, I was hoping that it would do well enough where they would invite me to do it for the bigger award shows, like the Emmys or something like that. But of course they never did because they're also, pandemic hit afterwards. But yeah, that was my brush with YouTube fame there, guys. That was my brush with YouTube fame. YouTube fame, being with these creators. It's different. It's a very interesting crowd, these YouTubers. YouTubers are a very interesting bunch. So I can only imagine how more cringy it could be today. But I will say something that, that turned me off a little bit about... what's it called? About Casey Neistat. I'm still a gigantic fan. Love what he does. But, there were these podcasts that he did where he outright said he doesn't like helping people. Not one-on-one, okay? I won't say, at all, right? I'm sure he likes it when people are inspired by his work and all of that and everything he's done. Great. But in terms of, one-on-one, he doesn't like doing it. He cringes at it. He hates giving people advice. You know, one-on-one. Like, he would outright try to hide from people who are trying to get advice from him. Kind of turned me off a little bit. I'll admit, it kind of turned me off. And then I also had to look myself in the mirror when you hear that. Like, how about me, you know? Do I sound like that? You know, when I tell you guys, you know, I really don't want to do tutorials because it's not something I like to do, you know? It's not that I don't want to help you guys. Of course I do. That's why I'm here. And I want to help you in my way. And in essence, maybe that's what Casey was saying. He likes helping people, but in his own way. He doesn't want, because there were times where people wanted to be mentored by him and he would just actively hide, or he'd have friends that would come and ask him if he could just have a dinner with a buddy of theirs who's trying to be a filmmaker. He tries to actively avoid that stuff, right? So, so it's interesting, guys. It's very, very interesting. That kind of stuff. Like, I'm still a big fan of him, but when you hear that, when he's not willing to help somebody, it kind of takes the luster off just a little bit. But I understand at the same time. I understand. Again, some of you might think that about me, since I don't want like doing tutorials. You know, maybe that takes maybe it turns it off watching my stuff. It's like, oh, okay, James maybe doesn't want to help. So I don't want to help. It's just I don't like doing tutorials. It's not something I like doing. But again, like I'm drawing here. If there's if you have a question about what I'm doing, by all means, please go ahead and ask. But right now here, teaching's not for everyone, for sure, comic book Bob. You really like to teach. And that's coming from a teacher. I'm an actual teacher. I taught in school. But, you know, it's different on you. I like to entertain here. That's what I like to do. I like to entertain. But what I will do right now, I'm going to go over my picks for the Streamy Awards. Okay? I know a lot of you don't care. I know a lot of you don't even know who a lot of these people are. But, you know, on the YouTube space, you always look at who are awarded. And you always look like, and you always ask yourself, you know, if I were to win one of these awards, what kind of award would I win, right? So let's go just quickly, guys. That'll be a fun exercise. First of all, I'm going to ask you guys if you heard of any of these guys, okay? Have you heard of any of these guys? And secondly, who would you pick to win these certain awards here? Okay, so let's start with the top award, creator of the year. Okay. And I'm glad I'm not going to be here because I do not want to hear some of these speeches. But creator of the year, the nominees are Addison Rae, Ararak, Blogilates, Charlie D'Amelio, Dream, Dijon, Logan Paul, Mark Rober, Mr. Ballin, and Mr. Beast. Okay, so those are the nominees for creator of the year. Now, I think for most people, I won't say most people know. It's interesting because you get a guy like Mr. Beast who has over 100 million subscribers, but you put them in a room, and he would be more famous than the regular folk for sure. But there are a ton of people who have no idea who Mr. Beast is, right? But see, the guy like Bob would know, right? These are the people who transcended a little bit. Guys like Mr. Beast and Logan Paul, they transcended a little bit. We know Logan Paul. Some people only know Logan Paul from wrestling, right? Because he's such an awesome wrestler. Never seen such a more talented guy coming from entertainment. He's so good in wrestling. Only three matches in. It's pretty incredible what he did in wrestling. But out of these guys here, people I do watch, like Blogilates, like it's very niche, right? She does Pilates, right? That's what she does. Again, Addison Rae, Charlie D'Amelio, they're TikTokers, but are they really today? Like they're more like entertainment people now. They're more like streamers. Dream, Dream went super viral this year because of his face reveal. I actually think he's probably probably the front runner. Dream. Well, you would think Mr. Beast is the front runner. Like nobody does YouTube like Mr. Beast, right? Like he's royalty. He's YouTube royalty right now. Like nobody does it better than Mr. Beast. But can he win every year? So it's like, I don't think he's going to win just because he won last year. Last year? So, you know, Logan Paul, you know, and again, this is not YouTuber of the year. This is creator of the year, right? So out of this list here, I'm going to go Dream. I don't watch his content. If any of you guys watch Dream, if any of these guys, like I haven't heard of Dijon, but yeah, Gideon, never heard of Gideon before. Airrack, I've watched a few videos, but not many. So creator of the year. Now this is a better list than a few years ago. Mark Rober. I love Mark Rober. Mark Rober is a fantastic YouTuber. Mark Rober is the antithesis of you don't need to post every week. Like this dude only posts once a month, if that. But then all of his videos hit like 40 million views, right? All of his videos. Like Mark Rober is the antithesis of somebody with a real profession coming into YouTube and killing it. Like he's a former NASA engineer and doing some incredible things on YouTube. So if there's anyone here that I would suggest, guys, to watch the content, if you haven't already, I would say Mark Rober is probably the top one here. I absolutely love Mark Rober's stuff. Because as YouTubers, even though I don't do the same things, you try to incorporate what a lot of these top YouTubers are doing. Because they're doing something right. They're top for a reason. Because what I'm doing here, what we're doing, you know, with a lot of us being artists or in the comic book realm, you know, we have a very niche audience. There's only a certain amount of people who like watching stuff we do. So if there's a way to kind of incorporate some of the things that they do to make their videos a little bit more entertaining, hey, why not? It's worth a shot. They're doing something right. So that's why I like to study a lot of these bigger creators. What do they do that I can personally incorporate into my videos? Here, is there something that I could take from them? Like especially too, because you know my audience is starting to skew a little bit younger, which I do, you know. I do like to be a good influence. There's so many bad influences out there, guys. That's one thing I kind of want to be. I want to be a good influence. If I can be any influence at all to the younger generation, I want to be a good one. You know, I want to be somebody that, you know, that parents wouldn't mind their kids watching. You know what I mean? No controversy, no nothing. I want to be that person where they, you know, parents can trust when they go to my channel and my content, it's safe and they're going to learn something, right? That's what I want. So if I could achieve that someday, that'd be fantastic. We'll see. So that is creator of the year, show of the year. Okay. Show of the year. Let me know if you've watched any of these shows online. There's only a couple here that I actually watch. Challenge Accepted by Michelle Carre. Yep. Chicken Shop Date. Amelia de Moldenberg. Never heard of that one. Good Mythical Morning, of course. I watch that a lot. Hot Ones. Yes, Hot Ones. I Spent a Day With Anthony Padilla. I actually really like that series. I Spent a Day With. He talks to some really interesting people. Anthony Padilla. In Space with Markiplier. Love Markiplier. I don't think I've watched that show. RDC World. Never heard of it. Side Talk. Never heard of it. Twitch Rivals. Never heard of it. Unwild Presents. Never heard of it. So... Show of the year. Next year, it will be the Box Office Artist Morning Show. I am actually thinking about changing the name of this thing. I won't call it Marvel Style anymore, guys. Maybe I would call it the Morning Show. What do you guys think? Because I do more than just draw here. Like I want this to be entertaining. I want to talk. I want to talk about, you know, topics of the day. What do you think, guys? What should I call this stream? Should I just leave it drawing centric? Because this is pretty much a show. That's why I talk so much here. I also record this as a podcast, guys, by the way. So if you don't know this, if you miss a show, but you want to hear me talk, that's why I talk a lot. I'm trying to talk a lot more is because I'm recording this for a podcast as well. Let me know if you have a name for the show. Can I call the morning? Like, I was thinking about calling this show, like, James, the box office artist masterclass. I was thinking about calling it that. So I will teach you guys about art, give you stories about art, but also talk about some pop culture, news of the day, you know, stuff like that. So I am looking for a name for these morning shows, guys. Looking for a name. So if you guys have a name for the show, I would love to hear it. I would love to hear your name for the show. So maybe next year I'm going to win morning show of the year. Okay, but out of these ones here, I'm going with Hot Ones. I absolutely love Hot Ones. You know, wonderful interview show, wonderful premise. But I like a lot of these shows. Again, I like spending a day with my friend RB3 works on that show. But the Box Office Masterclass, Carrie O'Neill likes the Box Office Morning Show. Yeah, and instead of calling it Marvel Style, and again, because even that name Marvel Style is a little played out now. You know, and that's not all we do here. Like we sit here, we come every day, we talk, right? And that's what I like to do. So I'll ask you guys, what should I call these morning streams here? It's like the morning show, like a radio DJ. Popper's Papa. I don't know if I would call the show that, guys. I don't know if I'd call the show that, but that is what it is. Okay, let's go to streamer of the year. Now, maybe you guys can tell me if you guys watch a lot of video game streamers. Okay, but the one I'll go with for show of the year, I'm going Hot Ones. Okay, next year, the Box Office Artist Morning Show. That's what it's going to be. Box Office Artist Morning Show. There you go. Jazzing with James. I can get Jazz on here once in a while, too. Rambling with Rays. I like that, too. Rambling with Rays. Jazzing with James and Rambling with Rays. There you go. We'll combine those two, guys. Rambling with Rays. I like it. Okay, streamer of the year. We got Hassan Abi, I Show Speed. Some of you wanted me to draw I Show Speed. Kai Senat, never heard of. Kai Day, never heard of. Ludwig, I've heard of. Pokemon, of course, I've heard of. Quackity, I've heard of. Tarek, haven't heard of. Valkyrie, I have heard of. Fellow Filipino. XQC, I've heard of. So I'm not the one to comment because I don't watch a lot of streaming. I should, though. I should watch more streaming, mainly to see, you know, how these guys talk during the streaming, right? I should definitely watch a little bit more streaming. But maybe you guys could tell me who you think is going to win. I'm going to go with Valkyrie. Go, Pinoy! Go, Filipino! Filipino! Go, Filipinos! Us Filipinos stick together! So I'll go Valkyrie, but maybe if you guys have your favorite there, you guys would know more than me. I shouldn't be a judge for this category. I wouldn't know. Raise the stake, Mario says. Raise your art. Lulian wants my show to be called I'll Be Back in a Few Minutes. There you go. There you go. Kingfire likes iShow Speed, so I'm not too familiar with them, so. But then we got the international YouTubers. Forget it. I don't know any of these except for Cabby Lane. Maybe you guys know who these guys are. The Ansala family. I don't even want to pronounce these. I might get them wrong. Enaldino? Hikakin TV from Japan. Cabby Lane and Myth Pat. I'm going Cabby Lane because that's the only one I know. That's the only one I know. Yeah. And I don't blame you, Bob. You know, when I went to the Stream Awards, I took pictures with all these people. All of my friends had no idea who these people were. You know, you think somebody with like 10 million subscribers would be like famous? They're not. They're not famous. They're not very famous at all. They could walk down the street no problem. Now, if they're in a mall with or a place with a lot of kids, maybe they'd be a little bit more famous. But they're, you know, they're definitely not, you know, as famous as like a Tom Cruise or Well, that's why, you know, you get a guy like Dwayne Johnson. And again, not maybe a bad example because, of course, you know, he's super duper star. Dwayne Johnson, like you put Dwayne Johnson on social media and on Instagram, he has like 200 million followers on Instagram, right? Like you could go anywhere in the world. They know who Dwayne Johnson is. They're not, a lot of those people don't know who Mr. Beast is. They have no idea who Mr. Beast is. Now, the younger generation, though, Generation X, Generation Alpha, they'll know Mr. Beast more than these guys, right? So it all depends on when you grew up in your era. So next year, short form. I have no idea. I'm not even going to read these. I have no idea who they are. Okay, so individual awards. Breakout creator. This is one I could win next year, guys. Breakout creator. So I want, Abba says, box office high five mornings. That's not bad either. If you're listening to this podcast and you have an idea, let me know. Let me know that what I should call this podcast. I would love to know your thoughts. Okay. But let's see here. Breakout creator. Ben of the Week. Call Me Chris, who's actually a friend of mine. Kristen Titus. Never heard of him. Mr. Ball. Never heard of him. Ryan Trahan. I'm going Ryan Trahan for that one. If you guys didn't watch his Penny series, like this guy changed the game in terms of YouTube. His Penny series. Out of these three, Call Me Chris, I actually met because I drew her. I drew her and we have messaged back and forth. So I know her. Like, we're not friends or anything, but I know her. But she does some fantastic stuff on TikTok and fellow Canadian as well. Used to be a hairdresser. Used to be a hairdresser for movies, actually. But she does really well for herself. But as much as I love Chris, I am going Ryan Trahan for Breakout Creator. Next year, the Box Office Artist. That's the Box Office Artist Morning Show. That's what we're doing next year. Box Office Artist Morning Show. That's what we're doing. Okay, so there you go. Breakout Streamer. I have no idea who those are. I'm not even going to try. There you go. Collaboration. Okay, so best collaboration. So YouTubers who got together and collaborated. Now, when I did the Streamy Awards, the winner of this category was, I believe it was, one of the Jenners and David Dobrik. They won this. Was it Kendall Jenner? I forgot which Jenner it was. But let's see. Just Dustin, Hacksmith Industries, and Unspeakable. First YouTuber to break the orb wins $10,000. Haven't seen that one. Ludwig, My Game Show Broke YouTube. Mark Rober, Jim Browning, Trilogy Media. Prank Destroys Scam Callers. That is an amazing video. If you guys haven't seen that video, that's a great one. Raise and Shine Morning Show, Knuckle Sandwich. Raise and Shine Morning Show. There you go. I'm liking that too. Raise and Shine. Let's see here. Mr. Beast Extreme 1 million Hide and Seek, which I saw as well. It's a lot of YouTubers in that one. Okay. And by the way, I'm coming to the end of this Pillsbury Doughboy. So we might stop this stream and do another one, guys. So just letting you know that. Next one here. And Sam Colby, Call Me Chris, and Selena Spooky Boo. Also another friend of mine, actually. Selena Spooky Boo. Again, one of those that I drew in as a Marvel superhero. And then she contacted me. Lives not too far from me, actually. And actually, when my wife passed away, she sent me a really, really nice message. So Selena, she's really nice, hilarious, one of the most hilarious people I've ever met in my life. So I'm gonna go with them. I think the only one I watched, the scam callers was fantastic. That's a fantastic video. If you've seen that, you know, seeing people get their comeuppance in real life, that's a great video. But I'm gonna go with my friends, Sam and Colby, Call Me Chris, and Selena Spooky Boo. Because I've never seen this video. But they're friends of mine. That's why I'm going for them. You always root for your friends. Or let's say that's a sentimental favorite. But I'll say the Mark Rober one. That should win. Okay. So next one here. Okay. Creator product. What product do you guys think I should have? I could see myself like in the future having like my own line of art supplies. I could totally see that, you know, my own line of paper, my own line of pens and pencils, right? my own line, maybe even my own tablet, the James Ray's tablet. You know, I probably wouldn't do that on my own. I would probably like partner up with a company like Wacom has been really good to me. Maybe we could do like a Wacom, a box office artist tablet. An association with Wacom. You know, get the real people who know what they're doing, you know, and get a version of mine in there. Maybe that's a nice product I could do down the line. One day, James Ray's markers are beanies. That's right, Dolph. Dolph likes the box office artist beanies. That's the affordable one. Look like an artist with the box office artist beanie. The box office artist beanie, right there. There you go. So let me just add just a little bit more shade to here, guys, and we might actually do a new stream. Okay. So I'm just finishing off this one here. Okay, so the best creator product. So we got Feastables, Mr. Beast, got Happy Dad for the Milk Boys, Hollow Taco from Simply Neological, Holo Taco, Pop Flex from Blogilates, and then Prime by Logan Paul and KSI. I don't think I've tried any of these products. Never tried any of these products. Well, Happy Dad, I don't drink. That's a beer product, if I'm honest. I don't drink at all. I don't eat chocolate. I don't drink hydration drinks. I call pass on these. I don't like any of these products. I call pass. You know what's going to win next year? The box office artist pens. That's what's going to win next year. And associated with Micron, we're going to develop my own brand of Micron pens. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to tell Micron, hey, put my name on it. Just give me a whole bunch of money. We're going to make a whole bunch of box office artist Micron pens. That's what we're going to do. Next year, guys. Next year. That's what we're going to do. Let's see here. Next category here. Crossover. Okay. Now, this is interesting. This is an interesting category. Okay. Because, first of all, oh, you know what? We'll talk about this in the next stream. Okay, guys. So I'm going to end the stream right now. We're going to open up a new one. I'm going to draw the second character here. So this is the Pillsbury Doughboy here. Let me just erase. So I'm going to draw the second character here. And the next one we're going to do, who here likes bananas? Who here likes bananas? Who likes bananas? My dad loves bananas, and I'll talk about that in the next stream. But we're going to do the Chiquita Banana Girl next. Did you know Chiquita Bananas, they have a mascot? A lot of people didn't know this. My kids didn't know this till I showed them, because I love Chiquita Bananas. But if you look very closely on the Chiquita Banana, there on the logo, there's a girl there. There's a girl there. So I'm going to draw the Chiquita Banana Girl. There, look it up, guys. Look it up. Okay, or look at the thumbnail for the next stream. Okay, guys, I'm going to stop the stream, and we are going to come back and do the next one. Okay, I'll be right back, guys. I'm going to be right back. Thank you guys for watching. Join me in the next stream. All right.